my heart's set on giving it up for a while. I'm going to do it. Maybe I'll come back. But, man, I had an out-of-body experience that last couple laps there. I kind of found a line and wanted two. It wasn't scaring me. But three and four, I got to admit, I didn't know if I was flipping over a couple times. Vic Hill, thank Vic Hill for giving me all that power and got me out of trouble.
That caution there with however many we had to go left, I think 14 to go, he was pulling away from you. How did you catch him and pass him on that last lap?
Well, I don't know if he was having problems. I think he was getting tight as well, and he couldn't go up and enter the cushion like I could. Maybe he thought he had a little bit more of a lead, or I wasn't going to get that big of a run. Maybe he had a problem. All I know is I kind of got my one and two down. I can actually run with him one and two, and then three and four is a matter of get up there and get on the wheel. And I got to thank Mike Marlar, because if Mike Marlar wouldn't have been lined up behind me, I knew I had to get my best out of the car against the top, because he's one hell of a racer, and I knew he was getting everything out of his equipment, and I needed to do the same.
That last lap, describe that last lap. You take the white flag. He's about three or four car lengths ahead of you, maybe a little more. You're going down the back straightaway. You went into three. You didn't let out of it, did you?
I lifted for maybe a split second. I don't even remember. No, I had to lift just for a little bit. And like I said, I put the hammer down, and Vic sung me right around that zero card. Like I told you, I put one in his ass.
I think we just saw the race of the year. What do you think?
There'll be one next week. Don't worry about it.
I don't know what else to say. If this is it, thank you. That's all I got to say. All right.
All right. I love all you guys.
What a way to end it.
Yeah, this is great, man. I ain't teared up. I probably will eventually, but I love every.
I am. Great job, man. Right. What a finish.
All right. I love you guys.
Brian Birkhofer wins at Knoxville. Mikey Moore, how about it for the 157? What a race, Mike. If you had on the monitor, you had the fastest car going. You didn't need that caution, though. You might have went around both of them.
Well, I had a good running going there. And Brian, you know, he's got a lot of experience here. He changed lines there right when he needed to, and then it ended up, you know, getting him the victory. So either probably one of the two of us is going to win that race, just whoever got in that position.
Brian Birkhofer, son, what would you guys like to say about Daddy's win tonight?
Go, Berkey!
That's awesome. That's great. We'll let the family celebrate. His wife Alyssa up here. Chassis builder Mark Richards, Vic Hill down here, Brian Doherty, everybody at ASO. I mean, it's, I don't know what to say.
Right here.
Tell us a little bit about the end of the race.
We're not sure what happened first, but going into three, the either drive shaft yoke, torque arm, it broke, and we got fortunate to coast to second. You know, that's about all we could say.
You had a really good race car all night long, obviously.
Yeah, the car was really good, and I don't know whether the torque arm broke or, you know, what happened, but, I mean, it was still good enough to win the race until it actually let go. That's why we had to push in, and I'm sure everybody could hear it banging and clanging, and they couldn't even get it on the scales because everything's hanging out from under it.
Scoot together.
Right now. You guys see me?